Larry, we're here at the Open Grove match. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about your air rifle and the pellets you're shooting.
It's a 177 air gun. It's called a pre-charged air gun because it's got a tank right here that has compressed air in it. And then the compressed air feeds into the gun through a regulator that drops the pressure down. And it gets quite a few shots, maybe over 100 that are good, consistent, accurate shots. And this particular gun, you can stick your pellets right in the chamber right there. It's exposed. Close the hammer, the bolt there, and you cock the hammer. And when you fire it, that's what actually lets air come up through here and fire.
Now, do you do anything to accurize the pellets or sort the pellets?
Yes. These pellets, usually they're available in different batches that have slightly different size, head sizes and weights. So I pick through different batches shooting them to see which kind seem to work better in this gun. And then I individually weigh each pellet. That's considered one of the big secrets of getting these guns to shoot well. That and having a really good barrel, and I've probably gone through 8 or 10 barrels.
Shooter. I've been a benchrest shooter with centerfire ever since 1962, so it's been a while, so I'm used to benchrest shooting, but fairly new to airgun benchrest shooting. It's a heck of a lot of fun and terribly frustrating at times and very instructive.
Now, Stu, you're a pretty darn good gunsmith, I know that. Did you smith your own air rifle?
Well, I don't do air gun work per se. I did stock the rifle. I did that because I wanted to have something that worked better off the bench, more familiar with the way I shoot.
How does air rifle shooting compare with centerfire benchrest? It's got to be a lot different.
Well, in many ways it's not that different, except that my benchrest shooting with centerfires is group shooting, and this is score shooting, so from that standpoint it's different. But really it's kind of all the same. It's practice and watching the flags and paying attention. And the conditions and the flags are important in both, but if you miss the conditions with a pellet rifle, you're going to be out a long ways.
So you really got to watch those flags then.
Yeah, absolutely. You got to watch them in both sports, for sure.
Tim, we're looking at some pretty exotic hardware with amazing scopes and big adjustment knobs and dials and all sorts of bells and whistles. What's this all about?
Well, this is our rig output. This is our pressure input. We adjust our focus, side wheel type. This is a brake to keep the muzzle settled. We have a 45, pretty much a vertical grip, two-stage trigger.
What kind of trigger pressure is on there? What the pull weight?
We run about 4 ounce take up and 8 ounce break on some of the higher end, and if shooters can handle it, lower. So we can go down to about 2 ounces.
Are these air guns pretty accurate?
They shoot in light varmint. They can shoot probably in the probably quarter inch group at 50 yards, and in the heavy varmint, we could do closer to 2/10 or better at 50 yards.
Now, Tim, you've got a whole bunch of different guns here. This one has kind of a big tube on the bottom. What's that all about?
Well, tube guns are unregulated, so instead of having a reg output gauge, you're looking at the tube pressure on this gauge. And as long as it's between those red lines, it's going to be consistent. So the design of the gun gives consistency through a 1,200 to 1,500 PSI range. And then the shooter will pick his sweet spot where the gun shoots the best.
Now, that black knob that attaches right there above the trigger guard, is that sort of a breech block?
Yeah, it's your bolt handle. You can close the breech with this. You load your pellet directly into the barrel, close the breech, and then cock and fire. So it's a simple system.
Is there an accuracy advantage for the 22 caliber versus the 177 pellet?
Yeah, we seem to get blown a little less, maybe half as much in the wind. And maybe the light varmint gets blown four times as much as a heavy varmint heavy varmint 22. So a 177 heavy varmint, 20 foot-pounds, is not going to be as stable in the wind as a 22 at 815.
Better than usual day, and it was kind to me, and I don't always shoot this good, but I had a good day, even a little bit better than my usual.
What was the secret today? Just reading the wind?
I think I stayed patient, and I didn't get frustrated, and the gun worked good for me today.